Welcome everyone to RGN here for some more European Pro Series action. Again, the Open Qualifier 2016 Pro Series, and this is a lower bracket match. So, of course, one of the teams going home. We got Game versus Tricked. So, I'm interested to see how this is going to play out. I know a little bit more about Tricked just because I've seen them recently and such. We saw them versus VWS Gaming, 16-14 on Mirage. That's how they got here. So, again, I am Skrull, joined by Laser Jesus. And, well, it looks like Tricked have picked up a knife round. That being said, Stus 2, not... compared to other maps, not a huge deal.
Definitely not. I mean... You can call this 8-7 for T-side generally. But yeah, I'm in the same boat as you. I'm not sure how this one's going to go because I've only seen Tricked from the We Got Game side. I only recognize like one, maybe two names if it's the guy I'm thinking of. But the Lounge odds state that it's pretty much 50-50, slight edged over towards Tricked. So I assume we'll have a good game on our hands given that it is so close. I don't think everybody would just be betting blindly, although... That did get me in trouble before. So yeah, just waiting on one player to go live and for the We Got Game side. I mean, again, I gotta favor them just because of what I've seen from them. I mean, Flex can go off. We've seen Tobacco from some previous teams do well. So this roster's looking okay. But again, it's the Gauntlet, and it's a best of one.
I feel like if you were gonna blind bet on this match, you would hit Tricked just because their logo is so awesome. How could you not be a fan of them?
Is that a raccoon?
I believe it's a raccoon, and he's got like pistols of some sort, or maybe they're just like small sawed-off shotguns. I'm not sure, but nonetheless, really cool.
Copyright infringement. Rocket Raccoon. Oh, you gotta know who that is, Chad, right?
I don't. Is that like a childhood cartoon that I missed?
I'm done with you. Get into the game. Boy.
All right. Well, into the pistol round we go. So I'm shamed into it. We Got Game going to be on that T side. Tricked starting on the CT side. And we'll see what pans out here. We got Tobacco with Smoke and Diffuse Kit. Everybody else with armor. T side, we've got quite a bit of utility on Lipped to King. That's an interesting alias. And NPK as well. And they head off towards B fairly early and quickly, walking into the upper tunnels. No real aggression towards lower. You can see Flex is actually watching that. So this looks like we're just going to see a B bust of sorts.
Yeah, I think so. Scar is still waiting at the back of top mid, but Tobacco, interestingly, the solo B player bought a smoke. That's kind of interesting. I usually don't see that too often, players preferring a nade, but oh my god, the bombardment of nades right through the back, through the smoke. That was just checkmate for Tobacco. Nothing he could do.
Wow, they drop their own smoke so they can run like nade stack back of platform, and if someone's there, he's guaranteed dead. That is one of the coolest things I've seen in a while.
We'll
see if they're going to hold on. Trick, just execute and retake all together, and that's exactly what you need to see. Insta with 4 kills on the round, and I'm almost a little like tilted that because that entry was so cool that they lost the round, but Tricked, you can't take anything away from the way that they retook all together.
No, that was teamwork at its finest. Everybody bursting out of the smoke and the window at the precisely same time. Everybody calling out which spots they're checking. Everybody hits their mark. But what a beginning to the round if We Got Game. Not only do they put the smoke down, they wait. They wait for any potential nades to come back through the smoke from Tricked. So after the smoke, about 5-10 seconds of the smoke, then they double nade the back. And it's too bad for Tobacco because, yeah, you're not getting out of there. As the long rush begins for We Got Game. Just enough utility to get him out of the doors, but yeah, the firing squad lined up from Car, and not gonna happen for We Got Game. And if it gets down to retake scenarios, like, we could take so much about what we just saw on that B retake.
Definitely, and well, Tricked gonna follow it up without losing a single member, and of course that's fantastic for them. And yeah, what a way to start the map. I hope this this just continues this way. We Got Game. I imagine we're gonna see more neat
bias
strategies. No, not at all. As well, we'll see how this next one pans out. We have AKs, we've got a couple smokes, not a lot other than that, to be honest. Two flashes, Insta with a tricky smoke here allows him to go into lower dark fairly covered. Ooh. But NJ decides to head out to catwalk and he goes down immediately. So a bit of double aggression there, and their op is now out of play. Insta taking a lot of damage with no real gained control at all for his efforts. He just falls back towards B. So not a good start here for Tricked. We Got Game. Maybe they can work off of this.
And not a good start at all. I mean, Trick, they invested heavily into the op. Third round, that's a big investment, but ooh, Flex. He'll grab one towards
through smoke.
Just oh, really? That's a nice little play. And now he's going to come back, but is he going to get there in time? Good flashes from Flex, but he has a lot of work to do. He has to defend the bomb site. His teammates have no map control. They're just now trying to flank up towards the catwalk. And as long as we got game keep the catwalk smoked, I don't see a way they retake this.
Scar dropped a perfect smoke. That being said, they right-click a flash through. But we got game coming up with all the frags there. I was a little worried. I think Scar was full white as they dropped that flash, but he had teammates to help out. And again, as long as you, like you had highlighted, as long as they keep that controlled catwalk with multiple players, they're just fine. So this is going to leave a situation. Flex probably just going to save his weapon, but this is one of the benefits of having a buy this early on in a third round when you get that plant in the first is there's not a lot of money on the Trick side.
Yeah, and they invested it all into this round. They knew the third round AKs were coming out. So Alan, he decides to throw a surprise at We Got Game and come up catwalk with the op. That's something you don't often see is the third round aggressive op on catwalk, but he misses the shot. You invest so much into that one potential missed shot, and then all of a sudden you're in an eco situation. You just got hard reset. But they have enough money where I think they'll only have to save once, especially if they keep this weapon on Flex. But I expect we'll see something interesting out from Tricked on this round, or they're just going to play standard.
Yeah, Flex actually ended up doing a lot of damage there. That should have been, I think it was going to be four left up. Yeah, and then he ended up with a triple kill. So only two left up. That'll keep the economy low on the T side. Good news. Moving into this next round is, of course, they want to minimize how much economy are able to grow on a round like this. And that's where I see Flex coming into play. He's actually going to boost a player up into that box and CT spawn, just in case there's a mid to B of sorts. Tobacco pushing up close towards upper tunnels. I like that. That's interesting. That's a small. I think he just tried to mask the way he jumped onto the boxes with the P250 shot. That's a very cool detail. And Flex, he's going to be wandering over, and this could work out very well for Tricked.
Maybe it's going to come down to Flex distracting. Oh no, they check Tobacco spot right away, and now Flex is everybody peering down. The op misses the shot. That's going to give him buy some more time, but he gets flanked by Scarl. Where's the rest of the squad? There's a smoke up, so probably not too much more for Tricked. Wait a minute, Insta. He's lurking through the smoke. He needs to get the headshot, though. There's more T's on the way. His teammate's not there just yet, and everybody's just going to run through the smoke. Nick realizes what's up and begins spamming through. Though, two kills. I guess that's enough.
I thought that was going to go way better for Flex there, in that he throws a flash when he's behind that double stack, and it kind of white screens a couple players, allows him to grab one, but then one of his teammates flashed through the double doors for him, and that like completely white screened them, and I think that's where the second kill came in, but unfortunately just nothing else came of it. But I thought off of that one flash that could have made it work, but nope. We got game. Able to keep three alive, take the round. Now they've got a buy to deal with, and CTs don't have a fantastic look here in that there's no op. You got NJ with the FAMAS and such. They're going to put two towards long early, and we got game is actually going to put some presence towards long A-ish, just outside of their side of the doors. Nothing going on too quickly. They don't even have presence in tunnels, so to speak. So, slow look here. Expecting some aggression, I imagine.
Yeah, they give up middle completely. They got, they'll occasionally spot it from either long or B. But with this setup, you're really relying on your opponents to go with a hard commitment. And specifically onto the A bomb site. Because if you give up mid control and then a mid to B occurs, well, it's really difficult for your two players in B to hang onto the bomb site. And we got game. Are shifting into the middle area. Are they going to play the catwalk mid to B shift game, or are they just going to commit? I mean, they got all the utility in the world to, sell whatever fake they want. They can, sell multiple with their nade set. And for Tricked, all they have is flashes. We got game is creeping out middle, realizing that the real estate has been left open. How far do they want to go with it? The mid to B smoke is up, and Tricked do not budge with their setup. We got game is going to commit onto A. That's a big duel won by Alan, and they're going to commit straight into three.
Here we go. We're going to try and take it onto the A-bomb site with very little time left. Netrick playing very passive. He'll lose his teammate as Flex goes down at the ramp. But Netrick with this position, they don't check it. 10 seconds remaining. And that should be the round here as Shouldn't be able to find Nedrick and the bomb plant, and indeed he does hold his positioning long enough that MPK goes down after the time. That's so unfortunate. $1,500 on him, and tricked. Just able to, that almost comes down to how the start of the round worked out for We Got Game, and I think they just expected. You saw how much control they got towards middle, and just still nothing. Like, very, very minimal peaks from tricked, and nothing given up in that regard, and then eventually that duel towards long when they decide to take on A, and just didn't pan out with how little time they had.
If the duel at long is won by We Got Game, that changes the dynamic of the bomb site entirely. And Lipped to King. He goes with an AK. Must have been banked pretty heavily. AK, no armor even. He wants to find some entries for the rest of his teammates. And where's We Got Game going to go here? Ooh, the 3B for tricked. And if it's a mid to B, oh, with a double. One through the head. Wow. Oh, one through the wall. Allen, the eco wrecker right now. Mid. Yeah, you shall not pass.
Yeah, wow. That's some nice shots from him. The AK. If he got the instant headshot, maybe. But aim punch, obviously, very difficult to deal with. And I almost expected with... He evens out the money with a weapon like that. But I feel like if you're going to even out the money, why not Tech-9 armor instead? And then you don't have to deal with the aim punch. But again, there is the factor that you just immediately headshot someone and you're trading off a teammate. And I can see arguments either way. Nonetheless, it's going to be not a forced buy necessarily. They're going to keep themselves around that 2.5K mark. And we'll see what they decide to go with. But if we see another round where... Like five left up for tricked in the last round. If they can get another round like that, that's going to be huge for them.
Especially if it's a B commitment here from We Got Game, and you know tricked don't even have to use all that much utility. We Got Game getting mid control, retaining control of the tunnels. I expect the mid to B to come out pretty soon. Allen's going to get a chance through the smoke. I'm wondering what We Got Game is waiting for here. Maybe just the mid to B smokes to fade. They are going to keep at least one additional player towards A, as you know, making noise towards catwalk is David. And when there's only one guy kind of tapping around like that, it's kind of easy to figure out when you're the one player holding catwalk. Like, is this a guy selling a fake? And then part of the higher meta is, you know, you have one guy, say, on Inferno at B. You have one guy smoking to B and one guy flash. And then just wait, make it look like a fake, and then the rest of the squad is already there. But it's a little obvious for me what We Got Game is doing, but maybe they could find the entries into B. They're allowed out mid to B quite quickly. Insta-caught with a nade out. He needs support from his teammate. Nobody's coming from tunnels, though. This is going to allow the two trick players in the bomb site to focus all their attention on the players storming through the window and double doors. But not the best of rounds from We Got Game, given what they invested.
Yeah, I feel like maybe... Like you had stated, if they had some upper tunnels players, that could have worked out a little better. I thought that it was still going to pan out simply due to the fact that there was no, like, contesting toward middle at all. The player in CT spawn, it's not like he was on top of the boxes where he could at least do some damage. I think he put a little bit into one player spamming through, but that was pretty much it. But still, good hold from tricked as they are able to secure that one and keeping four alive as well. So again, we see their economy doing big things. Whereas We Got Game going to take this next, as again, they've still had some fairly creative strats in my eyes, and I'm excited to see if they can pull out some more. But Trick, definitely formidable opponent. We can see NJ pushed up on catwalk here, looking towards lower, and at a certain timing, we'll see around now, he's going to be pulling back to the op and drop instead. But for the moment, he did have intel. No one towards lower. We Got Game just... Another slow work from them as finally they take into lower tunnels.
Yeah, this is a really methodical default. I mean, it's like act one, we take top mid control extremely slowly, even waiting in lower B. A lot of teams will peek that right away. And then act two, they'll begin to open up. And they're going towards the catwalk, but Allen, he's here with the op and drop. Nice little shoulder peek. No way Allen's hitting that one. Got to have super swift reflexes. But whenever We Got Game has attempted this A split, the long player has always lost the duel to the CT. And Flex is going to have another one versus one. I think if We Got Game can just win this long duel, they might be able to finally take into A.
Find out if this is going to work out. 40 seconds as they are grouped up on Cat. And the nades... are reigning over. NJ with a nice incendiary towards that elbow area and counter flashes, keeping them towards Cat. Very important as there's very minimal time, and that's going to be Nonik going down. NPK to follow. And with the amount of time remaining, they've got very little chance to even get the bomb planted. As we can see, David caught out on catwalk, trying to find his shot. And the long duel, I don't think it ever even occurred.
No.
Yeah, Lip King just hung out, I guess. I'm unsure what actually occurred there, what caused him to put the brakes on, but I imagine the idea is he goes when they come out cat. But anyhow, nonetheless, tricked with the hold. We got game. They have very little time for things to go wrong when they execute with only 40 seconds. It seems like a good amount of time, but if trick land an incendiary that's going to stop you in some regards, as well as good counter flashes, that eats up a lot of time.
And I'll explain it more after the long rush occurs, if I remember, of course. But ooh, good flashes by We Got Game. They're allowed out. They could just catch the players falling back. The anti-flashes are good too. Now the Tech Nines begin to swarm. There's the Allen and Netrick. All right, I think they're going to be able to stabilize here. Maybe Skara catches somebody on the flank. But the long take, or excuse me, cat take that We Got Game attempted. There's a couple ways you could do it. You can either smoke close to catwalk in hopes of dodging the op at rail or the rifler at rail, or you could smoke the top of or close to catwalk near the boxes in the bomb site. That'll allow you up, but of course then you have to run through the smoke to challenge in the site. But they didn't execute with their flashes. Like, the opera was blind at least three times, but he became unblind before anybody was even challenging him. And you're supposed to drop your player with the first set of flashes into the CT spawn so you can simultaneously take. So if they're going to attempt that catwalk play again, I think they need to tighten it up a bit.
Yeah, no, I would have to agree. As David finds a nice shot towards middle. It's a nice start to the round. He does get legged off of it, as there's actually a lot of bodies towards that mid double doors when he initially took that peek towards that suicide lane. But nonetheless, again, they do find that pick. Flex is getting aggressive here, though, and he decides to push through. That was a flash through from his teammate. Almost panned out, to be fair, but just too many to deal with. I think it blinded one of the players directly on the other side, but another one playing an off angle took him down, and I think he actually ate some of the flash himself, so tricked, gonna have to work back from a 3-on-5, and they've built enough economy that if they lose this round, like, they'll have a solid buy moving into the next, that'll be alright, but We Got Game, they gotta be putting numbers on the board, and this is a good start for them.
Yeah, it just brings back the old saying, if it's not broke, don't fix it. Trick trying something new, or I suppose they got aggressive on some of the rounds earlier, but I don't think Trick's aggression has been working as much as it's failed them. And this round especially. But ooh, We Got Game. Bad guess. They're gonna go to the bomb site where everybody's residing. Netrick, he'll be fast on the flank, so this is best possible 3v5 for Tricked.
Here we go. 30 seconds remaining. NJ not gonna hit first body here as they're running on in. He's gonna lose his teammate. Needs to find a highlight clip more or less as he goes down as well. David to find it. Netrick now all alone.
Wants to be a hero.
Oh man, fire dumped on his head, quite literally. And yeah, not looking good for Netrick, as it looks like We Got Game going to be able to secure this one. Indeed, will be the case. And surviving the four as well. That's cannot be undernoted, as that'll give them bit of a shot. Even if they lose the round, they'll have a bit of money. To be fair, though, they will be buying quite a bit of utility, as they had very little survived through that round. In terms of utility, that is, of course, they had players surviving with rifles, but brought down a little low as they want Molotovs. Yeah, just making sure, right? As the next one, but We Got Game. Got to bring in this next one.
I don't expect Trick to go with any aggression here. And We Got Game. How are they going to do the same exact lower B stuff? They're really worried about the catwalk aggression, and Tricked has been doing it, so I don't blame them. But so meticulous with the timing of when these players come out lower B. So now the opera will clear that nobody's atop. Xbox smoke will go down. Oh, I'm just going to molly off catwalk, and then the players eventually will work out lower B. It's interesting to note that, because a lot of other teams, most other teams, won't wait like that. But slowly creeping out mid as We Got Game. Netrick is the mid player. And he might get caught out. I mean, an AK is going to be posted up whenever he decides to peek. But Netrick, he's playing this really soft. He's going to molly off the exit, but nobody's there. So We Got Game prod out mid. Don't find much. We'll see how this alters their setup. Is ooh, Tricked. Now they're going to double up at mid.
And Insta getting flashed in. Doesn't find a shot immediately. He's going to dump another incendiary towards the double doors. And they'll boost up onto those boxes and CT spawn. And yeah, I love the teamwork towards middle from Tricked. Even when Net Trick was inside a CT spawn, I think he spotted one by jumping at that at the box there, and he called for a flash as he incendiaried, and that allowed them to regain control. But hold that thought, Tobacco, with plenty of players behind the smoke and upper tunnels. This is going to... Oh, he dodges a smoke and a flash. They start running through.
He's a genius!
He only got one and a half. Oh, he's not finished. Him and Insta just combined to massacre the B-side push. David now left all alone, and he's going to be flanked from upper mid. Tobacco with the hard read. That was beautiful.
And I thought it was clever from We Got Game 2. They just stopped Trick's aggression at long in the previous round, so the chance that they're going to do it again and find out that everybody from We Got Game is grouped up towards the B tunnels, really slim. And they just pushed out mid and made sure that nobody from Trick was up close. Then they realized both players from Trick are close mid, so why not try B? They had a 3v1 for a little bit there, but Tobacco, the genius play. We see the long rush come out. We Got Game. The entry flashes are good. They're not dying initially as they come out long, but this is the part where they usually get shredded.
Net Trick does go down. NJ looking for another one, as we will see Lip2King, next victim, as it's a 3-on-4, and they might vacate long here. It looks that could be the case. Trick, they haven't pushed up middle or anything to that effect. In theory, I guess they could have, hence We Got Game playing a little slow, but now regaining control as they head towards T-spawn and break back towards middle. But to be fair, it's a little separated at this point, and I imagine at some point they will group up and hit together again. At least I'd like to think so, as they still have a full minute. But actually, Insta is going to smoke the mid double doors and Xbox's smoke, so that negates any vision towards T-spawn and any intel that they could gather that it's a B play, and Tobacco's going to be alone.
They've actually sold this really well, because Alan inside of the A bomb site has to still be worried that somebody could be residing in pit. Then the Xbox smoke goes down. That insinuates that We Got Game is coming up the catwalk. So they go towards the B side, where again, it's only one player, but who is it? It's Tobacco. Deadly as always.
Right, the real killer here.
But that was like Navi-esque by We Got Game. They actually read that and sold that beautifully. But unfortunately, there's an op there that can hit shots.
Yeah, no, not bad at all. And yeah, that catwalk smoke as well, coming from them. It's great stuff. Sell it towards A, and We Got Game still on 3, though. We've seen some pretty nice strategic stuff from them, but when it comes down to it, again, the round before last, I still can't believe Tobacco was able to dodge, like, the incoming smoke and flash. Like, that's, again, a little bit of fortune. It's gotta be, as well.
I mean, two people running at you with their backs turned.
Well, no,
you gotta set that up.
Yeah, well, like the nades before that they threw through that smoke, like if they just hit him in the body, you know a player's there, right? So like,
yeah,
dodges nades that are just like flying his Matrix style, right? Just limboing as I neglect the B side rush that just gets absolutely decimated. Tricked on 10, and We Got Game. They still haven't been able to put more than again 3 on the board.
It's really unfortunate for them. A lot of these rounds, I feel like they definitely could have won. And the strategy is there. The craftiness is there. At what point, I mean, do you throw your slow stuff out of the window? I mean, they're getting out long, and they're flashing out long. That's a big deal. If you can make it out of that long corridor, you're doing something right with your nade work. But there it is. Tobacco pushes up mid. He's got a guy pushing close. Ooh, sticks around a bit too long. There's already a B flank coming through. Tricked, doing very well at wrapping around and realizing where the T's aren't and what ground that they can gain. But Netrick's close to mid, and he's got a bunch to deal with. They're storming out. Good damage done by Netrick.
Yeah, and Scar, he was legged by an earlier op shot through the doors from Tobacco as well. So very low here as they enter into B. And what are the chances they expect Insta to already be in tunnels? They're clearing a little bit, but NPK falls to the headshot of Insta. Now it's only Scar, 1v3. Not looking good for him, as they thought they had some control there. But again, just clearing the bomb site, at least for one of the players, was his demise. And smoked off in upper tunnels, and that's where two of the CTs are. Scar is going to go for the plant here, not a bait. Does get it down, but with minimal hit points, it's hard to favor him.
He's just got to become flawless and robotic with this aim. Does find some cover.
Ooh.
Bit too tall. Couldn't get low enough. So that's 11 now for Tricked. We Got Game. It's just, they're struggling here. And with, you can tell they put in a lot of work to this map too, with the way they work on their T side and then their ability to flow back and forth. The ideas are there, but it's Dust 2. I mean, just frag out at this point. You're down 11-3. I really think their best bet is to go for that long control and not rush up long, but just, you know, sit inside of the pit, because a lot of teams will struggle to get out long like that, and they're doing it well.
So just to, I realize we're moving into a fairly important round, but just to go through the veto phase, we actually could have gotten Cash or Mirage. It was randomed on Dust 2 out of the three. I just wonder how it would have gone, considering how the strategies go for We Got Game, if they got Cash and Mirage. Cash a little bit like Dust 2 in that you can kind of, it's similar in some regards into how you can take duels and such, but it is maybe a little bit more strategic. And again, I wonder if that would have favored We Got Game more. Not that Tricked is any less strategic. Their CT side's been impressive. But anyhow, enough about that as we move into the final round of the first half. And We Got Game, of course, desperately need it, as four rounds. This is not a standard scoreline for this map.
If this one would just provide them with a small buffer to lose pistol round, but it's Dust 2 and very hard map to stay consistent on, I'd say specifically on that CT side, given what options the T side has. Let's see if they could do it better this time. Yeah, the flashes, they run out with them this time. So We Got Game. This is what I was missing in their previous long take, cat take, excuse me, and it works out flawlessly. They run out with the flashes, they dominate the bomb site.
Yeah, Metric actually dropped a crucial incendiary. You can see how much damage is dealt. That's pretty much from, well, a little bit of bullets, obviously, but also mostly the incendiary that they ran through when they were a little blind as well. So it gives a good chance on this 3-on-5, and Tricked has been damn good on the retake. Ooh. Oh no, it begins. Yeah, they have catwalk control, but there's still a smoke here, and they're not going to be able to challenge as there's two players posted up, coming up from Lom, Lick to King with no chance.
That retake was immaculate.
It's so difficult because, again, We Got Game, it's not like they're doing anything incredibly, like, stupid or anything like that. You know what I mean? Like, their positioning wasn't awful. It's just there was enough utility and Tricked. There was enough damage done on the defense, believe it or not, with five alive, that the retake wasn't too difficult with what they had equipment-wise.
And the initial players peeking, I mean, there just wasn't enough firepower to deal with three members of We Got Game rushing up from the CT spawn. Tricked were trying to hold onto the catwalk, and that generally that's not a bad idea. But then We Got Game, since Tricked went fast long, all the B players and the mid player had all the utility in the world left because they didn't have to use any of it earlier in the round. So that retake, I mean, from Tricked, either more players peeking or more players covering the bomb. But then again, you don't expect Flex to just walk up and get two quick kills. Into the second half, We Got Game. They need a lot of game.
Yeah, definitely. And just a quick thanks to one of our new sponsors, CSGO 2x. If you guys want to use our referral link, again, CSGO 2x or 2x.com/RGN, you can get a free 300 credits. But anyhow, going live here into the next pistol round. Again, best of one. Loser's going to drop out of this open qualifier. Not a fun spot to be in. And Tricked, obviously, with a massive advantage moving to their T side. And, of course, that's going to allow them to even play a little bit more loose. Not to say they're trying any less hard. That was a weird way to phrase it. But that's kind of what I'm getting at, in that they can play a little bit more relaxed with the amount of rounds they have. Flash out long is it's going to be Scar at an NPK. And they will fall back. Not a bad nade. Scar gets one on the fallback as well. So 4-on-5.
Ooh, they're trying to cross through. Oh, the cross is handled and then some. Wow, what a shutdown from We Got Game. That's a way to start the half. Give your team a rally. Get all hyped up. Flawless round. But Tricked have an opportunity here to silence them, and I expect the fourth spy to come out.
I think We Got Game's just a second half team. It's just the way it goes sometimes.
The rope-a-dope. Right?
They just kind of play possum all first half, let them have a lot of confidence, and then this is how it begins. All headshots on the pistol round. Just an immaculate play from them. And, well, they're going to push up middle. Tricked is posted for this kind of thing. So need to be a little weary, and they will fall back. As, again, they push all the way up and fall all the way back, and all the damage that was dealt was done to the CTs.
Yeah, it puts two people, if We Got Game, right in headshot territory. Of course, everybody in there with when going against the Deegs of Tricked. Tricked definitely can turn this into more of a default-style round with the amount of utility that they have, and that's what is going on. We Got Game with a 3-2. So when this setup is utilized by the CT side, then it puts some motive on the T side to try to stretch out and get the feelers going out mid and see exactly where the CTs are playing. Because if you just dedicate onto the A bomb site, which it looks like Tricked is doing, this is kind of what you want in the 3-2 setup. You want them to take up into the A bomb site. It's going to come down to the headshots. There's not a ton of utility for the players inside of the A bomb site. Ooh, David's getting aggressive. Oh, if he gets blind, that's over, but he catches Flex. He was going for the drop angle, and now David P alone in the bomb site. He's got a teammate at his back, actually, but I think it, wow. I thought they were going to hold.
Yeah, the nice headshots. Tobacco with one, and the other one, again, like you had pointed out, they were low enough that they could just fall to a single headshot. So good news there. And yeah, I thought that might work out, but again, the two players that were down that low were those two players holding on that A area. That being said, maybe the retake can be sound. Nonik and MPK, you can see the catwalk control on the two-on-two. They have a kit on MPK, but no smoke to provide any coverage. So we're running out of time here as they will decide to just stick the bomb, but now creating a 1v1 insta, gonna try and pull them off and just buy enough time, but MPK able to pull it off in the end here. And again, with that kit, enough time to defuse, but very expensive round.
Nice play by MBK in the end. Taps the bomb, takes the wide angle, doesn't allow Insta to hit him with the shimmy and force the whiff. Probably a round that We Got Game can try to grow that economy, and boy, do they need it. They need to survive with everybody. Otherwise, the next round, if Tricked wins it, could, you know, result in the game being lost and tournament over for We Got Game. The Deagle's invested. Couple P250s as well. Insta with a smoke and a flash. I believe Tricked will turn this into a mid to B. And until that point, just try to work these deegs.
Oh boy. That trick. Didn't take them too many bullets to find that one. We'll find an entry early towards middle. David gonna be put on the floor, and that's an M4 that, well, eventually Nonik, I imagine he'll go grab it, but this puts quite a bit of pressure on the CT side, playing the 2-2. And, well, they're going to find one more. That Skara falling, and NPK just going to stay in pit. So the bomb plant does come through. They haven't received any weapons. That's the downside, but we'll see if they can make this work 3-on-3.
Deegs need to find some heads. Allen, he's isolated inside of the bomb site. NPK not looking. Ooh, does significant damage onto Allen. And now the Deegs need to come out and defend the cross. There's one for Insta. The Deegs are going to work. Allen, he's been hiding this whole time, though. He needs to play the headshot. Just one player. Netrick, his Deegs been hot, though. Another situation where they need to try to defuse the bomb. Oh, no! The team kill from Nonik. And now he's forced to hop on the bomb through the smoke. Netrick, he needs to find him quickly. And he stops the defuse. Nonik blasts his teammate.
I can't believe that team kill came out. They're both peeking just wide, and I guess with the smoke in play, it's just spam. I was on the tease screen there, so I didn't actually see how the specific lineup occurred, but I assume, again, they put that smoke down to try and bait him out into them. Again, you want the T to think you're just sticking in the defuse with one of the players, but they both peek wide, and that team kill, not fun at all for We Got Game, as it's going to be a force buy coming into the next, not a surprise. We Got Game. Really want to try and bring the momentum back their way. And if they can't, well, they should be able to close. Skara with the D. Wow. We'll find that. And well, then, I didn't spot that, but shot, I imagine.
He's just shimmying back and forth at the car and just pre-firing. And he's finding people peeking him because there's so many people from Tricked peeking that he has targets. And finally, a Molotov will succeed in flushing Skara out. Took about $3,000 worth of a utility to get him out of that car corner. We
Look
got game.
Flank.
I think Tricked heard it, though, and that it needed to stay silent.
Yeah. It's just like, shh, come on, man. We were
You're pugging your teammate. You're trying to flank. He just comes up. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
Like, why would you do that? All right. Well, yeah, Netrick. You can see Netrick is all over this. Even honestly, they all are. Flex right behind Netrick as well. But to be fair, those are two low players. Maybe a lineup occurs where We Got Game trying to be optimistic here as Lip2King trying to hold a catwalk as Tobacco slowly inching on up. But to be fair, I like how passive We Got Game has played this fairly passive. But yeah, they flash out, but Netrick putting the hurt on him. NJ with the follow-up, and now it's only Lip2King as he's trying to provide something from the catwalk. But yeah, I don't think it's going to pan out anywhere near as he had hoped, as he heads back towards middle. And maybe from CT spawn, he can maybe grab a weapon here, but not looking likely.
Everybody's low on the trick side. He could put a dent in the economy, but we talk about economy at 14.5 when the CTs have none. Kind of insignificant. We got game. What did they buy this round? They just four spot last round. I mean, what can you do? Do you save one more for a very small buy and give up the tie point? You really got no options at this stage of the game. And we got game. They're going to try to win out starting from the next round. Another round we're tricked. Can get that economy growing and the B rush. Only one guy here with a USP. And I mean, I put his chances at 1%, you know?
Huh? 1% sometimes all you need, but not this time. David, we're playing outside of the B doors. He falls. Teammates are going to drop as well. MPK now all alone as he does spot ahead from T spawn, but. Well, the hunt is on. As well, that didn't take long at all. NJ finds him with the AWP 15-5. And I like that we got game. Like, they're cool-headed enough that they're like, okay, let's save for this last round. Like, a lot of teams are just going to, at this point, at this scoreline, just force buying that last round and just go for it.
This is the way it used to be.
I like that they're like, okay, even though they probably, obviously, they're realistic in some regards, they still want to give themselves a chance here, and this is their best bet.
Yeah, I wish we had, like, a metric that would show when teams do this versus force buying every time. What are the odds at a comeback, or, like, out of 100? But there's just so much variance that I don't think that'll ever happen. A tricked. 10 chances to close it. Well, I'd probably... 7 of these being gun rounds if we got game win out from here on out and make it a tie. So that's a whole lot of gun rounds that we got game got to stop. And this would probably be the most difficult one. This will be the least equipped. We got game trying to hold on to the mid to B. They do got David close in the smoke. Maybe he could find somebody. Ooh, he's got a little gap in the smoke to use as it's
they re-smoke. David's like, come on. I had something there, but I was going to play on top of the boxes. The mid to B underway, and can David get anything done here? Is Slip 2 Kings going to try and fend off from the window before they even approach into the bomb site? And David just struggling with these boxes, couldn't get anything done, and that could be that.
I think so. And they still got a player at mid for Trick. Ooh, he's dealt with, though, so Skara does at least eliminate one of the remaining Trick players. But they have to come up towards lower B. I guess they're just going to try to rush through the smoke here. They don't got time to wait for it. They need to go right now. The flash has come over, but the flank is in route. They're going to get sandwiched in. That's all she wrote. Tricked, dominant on the CT side of Dust2, making it easy on themselves to go for their T side. So I guess the 50-50 wasn't as close as I thought it was going to be. But we got game. They showed promise on their T side. It's not like Trick just ran over them, even though the score would tell you that. We got game came to play, but unfortunately, Tricked just too good today.
Right. Apparently, that's just going to be the way she goes. So, yeah. And like you said, they showed they have game. No, I'm not going to go there. Anyhow, that's going to be that. Tricked moving forward. They're going to face Eyes on You in the next lower bracket round. That's lower bracket round 4. Still plenty to go in that lower bracket, as it really is. Bit of a gauntlet, the best of ones and such, but we are going to do a little segment now. Again, one of our new sponsors, do some, a little bit of gambling. And Laser, I'll let you start it off a little bit as I need to sign in, actually. So, anyhow, CSGO2X.com. If you guys want to check out what we're doing and watch our bets in real time, definitely do so. And use our referral link. It's just the exact same thing, CSGO2X.com/RGN.
CSGO2X.com/RGN. If you haven't tried it, 300 free credits, which equivalent, I think it's like $3, maybe a little less, or I could have my denomination wrong. Either way, it's a game of chance. You try to run it all the way up. They give you the roulette. If you haven't played any roulette at the casino, if you're not like an established hedonist as myself, well, I can explain it to you. You get red, you get black. You put your skins in, you get a coin equivalent or a credit equivalent to whatever you put in, and then you try to run it up. Basically a game of 50-50 with a slight advantage to the host via the green, And if you bet on the green, of course, you win times 11. Seems like a madman bet, but if you look at the spread of what's been going on, and as I say that, there's a green. You would have won 11 times your bet. So wow. I'm going to bet like a wise man, though. And let's bet most of our stack. Let's go 100K on black. As you see, it's been three times red, one time green. There's methodology to it. A lot of people abide by it, but I'm more of a madman. But I'm going black this time.
Yeah. So here we go. Again, you guys should head on over as well. And again, if you use our referral link, you can just get some coins to play around with while we're doing this as well. Lots of fun. And we'll see how we do here as black is going to be our choice. That's Laser's choice. He's been doing much better than me when we've been doing these segments. So, oh, boy. Oh, boy. All right. Mr. Producer, how many coins do we have to work with at the moment? What?
I'm gonna need to borrow some of those. I lost it all yesterday. I gotta put some more in, Chad. But of course you gotta run it up. I'm gonna use this every time. It's just like Artosis said, if you're a StarCraft fan, when you're ahead, you gotta get more ahead. So right. You know what? Let's keep it rolling. We gotta go on black. Let's win it all back. 200K on black.
Oh boy. There we go.
You know, there's some methodology to people. Sometimes they say you bet 100, you lose it, you bet 200, you lose it, you bet 400, and then eventually you'll get it back, right?
Or lose your house. But hopefully you get it back, right? Hopefully you get it back.
And... Oh, man.
Oh, God. This would be the occasion where you might lose your house. All right, I feel like maybe my luck's a little better today, Laser. Maybe
what am I going to say to my e-girlfriend who lost all her skins?
Okay, I'm going to go a little smaller because, we'll just go with like 50K here. And I feel like I just need to go with red because why would I not go with red as black is just not, it's not working out. It's not panning out.
It's hitting. I wish I had any left in my balance. I'm creating a new account. I'm getting that 300 for the referral. I got to run it all the way back. Man, just lost 300. That's not a good look. I mean, you could be betting against us right now and doing quite well.
Yeah, that's the truth. And my red, the one time we go red, yeah, you would be doing great. We're just getting wrecked at the moment.
All right, what's our count at, producer man? Oh, we got 150,000 left in the tank. You know what that means. We're going all in on black. Okay. We got to let the dice fall where they may. We got to run it all the way back up. This is the fun of the site. This is what makes it so exhilarating. When you put it all down and you realize either I'm walking away with... you know, a jungle AK spray, or I'm walking away with the D-Lore. You got to go one or the other.
Oh, boy. Well, here we go. This is all or nothing here. All the marbles, and we are...
Stop!
We're such losers today. All right, we're going to have to talk with our sponsor and get some more...
Oh, man. All right, guys. So if you would have bet against us, you would have won significantly. Right. You would have quadrupled up. Yeah. Usually my luck's better. I mean, maybe not the past 2 days, but I have won in the past. Again, see how much fun we're having with this. It's just exhilarating.
Right. Yeah, I definitely got a head rush out of that as we're gonna be done for now on that, but definitely again, like Laser stated, if you guys come back, we will do this every broadcast. So if you guys want to do the exact same thing and bet against us, well, yeah, you should do that because you will make a lot of money. Anyhow, hope you guys enjoyed. I think our next broadcast is going to be tomorrow. We had a match tonight, but I believe it's rescheduled. Make sure you guys follow us on Twitter at GoRGNTV. It's where you can find all the information about our matches and such, as well as on the SIBO.com website. You can check out our brackets and where we're at in our tournaments, of course. Follow me on Twitter at Sprawl and at LaserJesus as well. So I hope you guys have a great one, and we'll see you next time.